Thank you, Sheriff Harris. Thank you for all the work you do to keep our community safe. Thank you for your team and all the work you do to keep our community safe. It is an honor and a privilege to be the State Superintendent of Public Instruction. It is a top priority at the NC Department of Public Instruction that every student has the opportunity to go to school, work hard, and succeed. An important part of that is making sure that schools are a safe environment. That is a top priority as superintendent. But it's also a personal priority. Just this morning, I dropped my own daughter off for her very first full day of kindergarten in one of our traditional public schools. It's a very exciting moment as a father. But like all parents, I look into that classroom and I see that she will have a teacher that will love her during the day, that will teach her, that will guide her. And I walk away expecting that she will be in a school that will keep her safe. That she will be safe. Her classmates will be safe. Their teachers will be safe. That is why we are gathered here today. The first day of school for the first month of school. I'm excited to talk about the efforts that we are taking as a community to help make our schools safe. It is going to take educators. Teachers and principals are working hard. They're working very hard to keep our students safe, but they can't do it without our help. We will also take lawmakers and the policies that they are working on. We will also take law enforcement officials and the work that they provide for our community to help keep our students safe. It will also take mental health professionals and making sure that we are addressing any students' issues or challenges before they escalate into a school tragedy. And importantly, the reason for us launching this together today, it's also going to take parents and students across the entire state of North Carolina working together to help us make sure this is a priority. So I will quickly go through, and I'd like to just briefly mention the supporters we have here behind us. From the General Assembly, I see we have Representative Dollar, Representative Pat Hurley, Representative Jason Sane, thank you for coming. From schools, we have from Cumberland County, Bruce Morrison, Director of School Safety. We have Chris Mays from Barnett County. We have Dr. Stan Winborn from Granville. From law enforcement, we have the Apex Department's Chief, John Letney. We have from Cary Police Department, Assistant Chief Ken Kinlan and Chief Tony Godwin. From the Garner Police Department, we have Chief Brandon Zudema. From Holly Springs, we have Chief John Herring and Captain Mike Patterson. From Rollsville, we have Chief Orlando Soto. And from our partners, from the NC Sheriff's Association, we have Eddie Caldwell, the Executive Director. From the NC School Psychology Association, we have Heather Bowling, the President. From the NC PTA, we have Catherine Peglow, the Executive Director. From the NC Association of School Administrators, our partners in the administration, the principals, assistant principals, superintendents, we have Catherine Joyce, the Executive Director. From the NC School Boards Association, representing school boards from across the state, we have Ed Dunlap, the Executive Director. And from the Professional Educators of North Carolina, Here's a Voice for Teachers, we have Bill Medlin, the Executive Director. And also a special thanks to the Center for Safer Schools. That is the agency within the Department of Public Instruction that is leading this work, that is working not just to focus on law enforcement or mental health, or tips that we can get out that parents and students can take. It is all of us working together. We are driving that through the Center for Safer Schools. Their staff members here today, and the Executive Director, Kim Martin, is here today as well. So the steps we have taken over the summer, with the help of the General Assembly, we are working to get more law enforcement officials into schools. We have awarded grants to get more school resource officers in schools across the state. School resource officers are trained law enforcement officers who are there in case the worst is to happen. They can help prevent a tragedy. But they're also there to help build a sense of community. They are additional personnel in the school that can help build that sense of community with students, with parents, with teachers. And also, they keep their eyes on everything in the school. They can make sure the school is secure. They can also help identify those students. students having issues and help get that student the mental health support they need. But we know that it's not just going to take law enforcement. We know it's going to take addressing students' mental health issues as well. So we also were able to award more grant money out across the state for innovative mental health programs. Programs where we can identify students, we identify their needs, and we get them the help that they need. There are also steps that teachers and principals can be taking to make sure their buildings are secure. I recently was in Cumberland County, where I was able to see how an open floor plan for a school was made more secure by putting up some simple fencing to keep anyone from being able to enter the school from the back and the side. Following protocols such as having all visitors come in through the main entrance and check in goes a long way to helping keep our school secure. It's also very important that teachers, principals, and students work with us. Don't prop open doors to the outside. Don't let someone in who is trying to get in through the side door. These simple steps can help keep our schools more secure. And of course, we're going to be working throughout the course of this month to let parents and students know the role they can play in helping keep our schools safe. It will be parents and students who will be the number one resource of information for us in order to keep one student's issues from becoming a school tragedy. If parents or students see that a student's behavior is becoming or abnormal, or their behavior is changing, they need to tell a law enforcement official, or school official, or mental health professional. If students see that a student is suffering from bullying, they need to tell an educator, a mental health professional, or a law enforcement official. Bullying is unacceptable, but now, even more than ever, in this day and age, we know that some of these school tragedies start because of excessive bullying. That also includes, and this is why students are so important in this, cyberbullying. Cyberbullying is going on in a range that is hard for school officials or law enforcement to be able to see when it's happening. We need students to step up, and we need them to help us identify where that cyberbullying is occurring so that we can help stop it. So today, I am excited to announce that in order to launch our efforts to spread this information across the state for all parents and students, I am proclaiming September to be School Safety Month. And I actually have a proclamation here that I'm going to read out loud.